is late breaking news from Eyewitness News 5.
Paul Folger again. We continue to follow this second fire in the Norman area. Chris Lee is on the ground. And Chris, I want to bring you in on this. We're looking at Sky 5 that is just above you. You're over in the area of Lindsay and 60th.
No, I am. We're still on the larger fire down here by 132nd and Cedar Drive, watching the Chinook helicopter make another water drop here. This fire is, I'd say, rather optimistically, the tide appears to have turned right now, and that's the reason why is that big helicopter has come in here and dropped. I was reading up the other day, that thing drops 1,300 gallons every time it empties that bucket. So that's really made the difference in areas where the firefighters can't get into the fire and get it knocked down. They're having to wait till it gets out around houses, and by that time, sometimes it's too late. Still not 100% sure. I have heard of that there were two structures that were destroyed in this. I'm looking at a structure across the field. I'm not sure if it was occupied or not. And then Sky 5 told me there's one a little bit east of my location. A lot of these people have been evacuated, and many of them were almost forcibly told to leave by the police. They didn't want to leave, and they've been told they have to leave as the fire was approaching their house. But even that area, the area to the north here that I was at earlier, I took a kind of peek in there before the police chased me out again, and they it appears that there's less smoke and less fire getting close to the houses. So hopefully this thing is they're starting to get a handle on it, but the winds and the heat may have other ideas, and we're going to be watching it, Paul.
Okay, Chris, thank you very much. Yeah, you can tell that big Chinook helicopter has made a big difference in that area. I believe you may be looking at one of the structures, yeah, of what's left right there. So that is something that is burned. There is nothing left right there. And but this was threatening 20 to 30 homes, and they evacuated all the people in that. You can see the crews on the ground there, but you know, you can see that there's just some light smoke there. So that's a very encouraging and a very good sign. You heard Chris Lee say, you know, you got to wonder about the heat and the winds. I was speaking with Rick Mitchell just a few minutes ago, and it is 104 degrees outside. You see that south winds, 15 miles an hour? Well, Rick is telling me that the gusts are up over 20 miles an hour right now, so that is concern to anybody out there on the crews and the ground out there. So we continue to track it here and at KOCO.com. This is that grass fire fight near Indian Meridian and Cedar Lake, and also we're following a second fire at Lindsay and 60th.
This has been late breaking news from Eyewitness News 5.